come the Jackets. Here's a centering pass, quick shot, and a save made. Rebound came back. Here's a shot by Jones, and he missed the net. Over. There's 10 left on the two-man advantage. Nick Schmaltz. Franz on a shot. He scores! Cody Franz, and that went right through Corposalo. A one-timer that he did not get all of, but it was enough. And on a two-man advantage, the Hawks take the lead.
Watch the head fake of this man right here. Well, it's Nick Schmaltz. Nick Schmaltz has got the puck, and he's going to freeze some people. And as he comes around the top of the circles, freezes some people in front, throws it back towards Franz, and he absolutely rips this puck. The one-timer goes through Corposalo. Corposalo, I think, thought he had it, but it squeezed somehow between his legs, maybe between his pad and the post. On Tortorella, he and Brad Shaw are upstairs, the head coach and assistant coach, and behind the bench.
Right, the puck out in front of the net, and the Blackhawks have doubled their lead. Laurent Dauphin able to poke it home, wide open on his backhand, and the 22-year-old has the Hawks' second goal.
Yeah, right off a draw. Watch the work by Thomas Yurko. Steals a puck in behind, and Dauphin just heading to the front of the net. There's the work by Yurko. And one hand, what? Tell you what, that took a lot of skill. One hand on his stick. He knew where Dauphin was, maybe yelling for it, and he just one hands it to number 27 out front. One goal last year in 29 games, and he's got an opportunity here to maybe solidify himself as one of the top 12 forwards in the Blackhawks.
Hayden made a good play. Here come the Hawks. There's a shot into the glove. And then to Hayden going to the net, drawing the attention of every Blue Jacket on the ice. Now we may have a scrap as he got locked up with Motree. An official is in between, so they're not going to be able to go here, it doesn't look like. But
it was Tyler Mott originally who kind of cross-checked Hayden. He wasn't dropping with Mott. That's when Motree stepped in. Watch the rush, and we talked about that nice one pass, a give and go. Backhand one-toucher, gets it back, and watch him go hard to the net. Now that's where he gets cross-checked right there in the small of the back. Not real happy about it, so he responds and trying to get the attention of the coaching.
The entire coaching staff talked about him and how well he has started camp, in the sense that of all the young guys, he and Alex DeBrincat have been the two most noticeable of the youngsters. So a real good start to him and an opportunity to make the roster, but he can continue on. But in this situation, it's a 5-on-4 for Columbus. They've got a power play. There's a shot off the side of the net from Dubois.
Michael Kempe cannot move. Another real nice shot block, but he's in pain.
Here's Foligno, put it in front. A shot went just up high from the Breadman, who was open here near the close dot here. And now Breadman centering pass did not connect. He's able to get it back. Left it Foligno. And got Abramoff at the front of the net, or near it. Werenski, a wrister, never got to the net goal. He'll try again. That's a good block by Dauphin, who hit, I think it hit him in the hand and stung him. A shot, one-timer from Panarin off the side of the net.
We've seen three or four real nice shot blocks here by the Blackhawks, but they're tired. They've been out there the whole time.
Oh. There's another one, a diving block by...
When he tells you to straighten up, get your skates back, he will.
Inestroza has room. He'll try to center, open net. What a save, Corposalo! A spectacular stop. After a great setup by Inestroza, somehow Highmore didn't score. Now off the end boards, and it, I believe, the back of Corposalo went in. The Hawks have their third goal.
Well, what a great dominating shift by this Inestroza line, and he really started it. That shot might have come from Ruta, who we've talked about a little bit, and got off the backboards. Watch Inestroza, though. Just go to the net, draw some people, and find the open man. Highmore absolutely robbed by Corposalo, but Inestroza stays with it, gets it back to the point, and it goes in off his own skate. Corposalo just trying to track that puck, and it goes off the back of his heel right into the net. Jan Ruta with his first goal, preseason goal. But that's good pressure. It's not a real big line. I really like the response here by the Chicago Blackhawks. Watch this.
Moss lets it go. He scores! A high wrist shot right by the blocker of Corposano, and the Blackhawks have scored too quickly.
We talked about Nick Schmaltz in the open, pad and the skill set he has. Deceiving skater, real smooth, and what a shot. And we're going to kind of highlight him here. Just an isolated look, a little stutter step. He breaks wide. He's got some room. He's got some space. And a high riser. I mean, that's clearly over the blocker. And that had a little zip to it. Not a lot of room up there. Maybe a 6-inch square, but he found it.
Going to start this evening.
It's just been very cool and calm back there.
Here's Hinostroza looking to add. He does. Vinny Hinostroza snapped it by the glove. And Corposalo having a brutal second period. Now is down 5-0.
Well, I've seen some skill out of that man. Vinny Hinostroza, not real big, but he's got quick feet, quick hands too. Uses the defenseman. Watch 44 Siebenhaler. Kind of freezes him, gets him to screen the goalie right here, and then puts it by the defenseman. Might have gone through the defenseman's legs. Corposalo saw it until it was by him. But that's just, you know, using what you got in front of you. You've got to screen the defenseman, get it by him. Maybe it goes in, and it certainly did for Vic.
Couple minutes. Look forward to doing it again. Thanks,
guys. You got
Kevin.
It, guys. Quick shout out to Edzo as well.
I love it. That a boy, Kevin. All right, underway now in the third period. As the Columbus Blue Jackets, not surprisingly, have made a change in the net. Matisse.
Hasn't
remember
been
having very many at all.
Yeah, we flow to this hockey game. Matisse Kivlenix. I believe that's what I was told through my earpiece, so I might just be calling him Maddie. Matisse Kivlenix.
A Latvian who had a great year. You saw some of those. Now Savard will try a long one. Oh, that was a redirect. Good save, Forsberg. I think that hit a Hawk stick out high and required a good reaction from Maiden.
Yeah, he's real focused. And if it didn't get directed, redirected, it came through a couple of bodies. And that's just focused right now. You know, goalies get into a zone where, you know,
anniversary of the so-called game of the century. He finished in a 10-10 tie. You know, when Notre Dame played for a tie. I just got a lot of people. Here's a long wrist shot. It missed the net. Jones. He scores. Seth Jones took the hot care for the end boards. 5-1.
Typically doesn't lose his crease, and here maybe overplays the one shot, tries to scramble back to his left, and overslides. There's a shot from the point. He was just a little slow to react. Didn't think he'd think it was coming all the way back to the point because he's getting up slowly, and then all of a sudden he realized the defenseman shooting it. That set
back. David Savard walks down low center, just missed the stick of Broadhurst. Now a long clips out. They score! A long wrister from Seth Jones goes in through traffic, and the Jackets on a power play. They've made it a 3-goal lead for the Hawks.
Good puck movement by the Blue Jackets, and Kelly Killer's getting a little tired. They've been out there almost 50 seconds, running around a little bit. And Seth Jones should be his second on the night, just wristing it through. Couple of bodies in front of Forsberg, one of them being Mark Stewart. He didn't see it. He was.
Well, Vigneault trying to drive the goal with a shot. Save Forsberg. Oh, what a second save. Anton Forsberg, a good first one, a dandy second one. And the Hawks still up 3.
Artemi Panarin just looking skyward. He had that second opportunity. Maybe didn't get a lot on it, but again, real good body positioning. Stops the backhand shot, and there's that follow-up attempt by Panarin. And I really like the focus, the readjustment there by Forsberg. Makes the initial stop and then just gets ready for the next one.